Welcome friends, in this video we will see about neighborhood of a point, what is meant by open set, examples of open set and theorems on open set. A definition of neighborhood of a point is a set n of R, this is subset of R, is called the neighborhood, is called the neighborhood. In short, we write this neighborhood by short form NBD, neighborhood of a point, suppose A, if there exist an open interval, which we denote by symbol I, containing A and contained in N, that is, in short, A belongs to I and it is a subset of N. This is the definition of neighborhood of N. What is N? N is a subset of set of real number. And if there exists an open interval which contain A and is a subset of N, then N is called as a neighborhood of A. The set, we write this set X such that 0 less than mod of x minus a less than delta. Look at this set where there is a no equality. X cannot be equal to a and therefore a is deleted. This is an neighborhood of, this is an open interval. Which open interval? This is a minus delta to a plus delta. All points we have taken from this open interval a minus delta to a plus delta, and where this x is not equal to a, this is called as a deleted neighborhood of a. Open interval a minus delta to a minus, all these points, suppose this is a minus delta, here is a plus delta, then all the x lies between this and somewhere here is a, and this point is excluded from this open interval, then this is called as a deleted neighborhood of A. Then the example R, the set R, which is subset of R, we can see that for any point, if we take a point 5, then there is a neighborhood on the real line which contain 5. We can take this as, suppose 4.9, we can take 4, we can take 1 from this side, we can take here 5.1, we can take 6, whatever may be, then this neighborhood, there exists an open interval which contain 5 and which is subset of R. Therefore, R is a neighborhood of each of its point. R is a neighborhood of each of its points. Its points, for any real number, we have an open interval which contain the point real number and which is subset of R. The set of rational number, if we consider the set of rational number, then rational number is not a neighborhood. It is not a neighborhood of each of its points. Any of its points, any of its points. For example, and very simple example, if we consider, suppose this is my 1 by 2, where 1 by 2 lies between these two points, 0 and 1, we know that. And if we consider this neighborhood, suppose here is suppose my 1 by 3 and here is suppose this point 0.6. Then we can see that this is an open interval. Which open interval? 0.3 to 0.6. This is an open interval which contain 1 by 2, that is 0.5. But this open interval contain both rational as well as irrational points, and hence it cannot be a subset of Q. Hence this I is not a subset of Q, it is not a subset of Q, and that means for any rational number there do not have any open interval which contain the rational points and which is subset of Q. Remember this, and therefore Q, the set of rational number, is not a neighborhood of any of its points. Again, we are familiar with the empty set phi. Phi is neighborhood of each of its point. Phi is neighborhood of each of its points. Why? In the sense that there is a no point of which phi is not a neighborhood. There is no point of which phi is not neighborhood. In that sense, this empty set phi is a neighborhood of each of its points. Then again, the union of neighborhood of a point x is again a neighborhood. Suppose union of neighborhood of a point x is again a neighborhood of x, is again a neighborhood of x. Okay, so these are the examples of, remember this definition, what is mean by neighborhood. In short, I will write here short form of this definition so that you can see that definition every time. What is the definition of neighborhood? Neighborhood is a subset of R. N is a subset of R. N is a subset of R is called neighborhood of a point if there exists an open interval. There exists an, what is a open? I is an open interval such that A belongs to I is a subset of N. If this condition is satisfied, then N is called as a neighborhood of a point. Now we show that non-empty finite set is not a neighborhood of any points. I will write this problem. What is the problem? Show that a non-empty finite set is not a neighborhood of any of its points, any of its points. This is our problem. For example, if S contains 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the four points. This set is a finite set. This set is a non-empty set, and we have to show that this set is not neighborhood of these four points. Now see the definition of neighborhood. When we said N is neighborhood, there must be, for to become a neighborhood, what is the condition? There must exist an open interval. And see the open interval contain how many points? Infinite points. I contain infinite points. And see here, if I is a subset of S, then S must also contain infinite points, but the number of points in S are finite and hence it is not possible. An infinite set cannot be a subset of a finite set, and that is there do not exist I such that X belongs to I and I is a subset of S, and therefore finite set, therefore S cannot be a neighborhood of its points, any of its points. Okay. Now we show that if we have two neighborhoods of a point, then their intersection is also a neighborhood of that points. Suppose if this is our problem again, if M and N are neighborhood of X, then M intersection N is also a neighborhood of X. This is the problem. M intersection X, what is given? It is given that solution. Suppose we let M and N are neighborhoods of X, and therefore X belongs to the open interval. Suppose A, we consider there exists an open interval x minus delta 1 comma x plus delta 1, and it is a subset of M. Here we have taken like this. Suppose this is my real line, this is a real line, what happened to this? This is my real line. I am once again drawing the real line. Suppose that this is a real line and here is a point X, and this point is X minus delta 1, this point is X plus delta 1. Again N is also neighborhood of X, therefore there is again an interval. Suppose that interval is X minus delta 2, X plus delta 2, this is another. And relation between delta 1 and delta 2 is, suppose delta 2 is greater, here is somewhere X plus delta 2 and here X minus delta 2. Okay. See the common points are this one, X minus delta 1 to X minus X plus delta 1, these are the common points to both the interval. Okay. These are the common points of this interval. We take that, suppose delta equal to minimum of delta 1 comma delta 2. Minimum, here delta 1 is a minimum, therefore this interval X minus delta to X plus delta, this open interval contain X and it is a subset of this X minus delta 1, X plus delta 1, and it is subset of M. It is also a subset of, here X is also belongs to this X minus delta to X plus delta, and which is subset of N. This open interval is a member of both the sets M and N, that is X belongs to open interval X minus delta to x plus delta, which is subset of their intersection, M intersection N. That is, for every point of the intersection M and N, there is an open interval I which contain x and contained in M intersection N, and therefore M intersection N is also a neighborhood of x. Okay. So we have proved that. We have seen what is meant by neighborhood and how the intersection of these two points is a neighborhood. Again, we have shown that finite set cannot be a neighborhood. Now, see the definition. A point x is said to be, next definition, and this is again a very important definition to us. A point, I am writing this definition, a point x is an interior point, is an interior point of a set S if S is a neighborhood of X. X is an interior point, that means if S is a neighborhood of X, that is, in short, if there exists an interval I which is subset of S and which contain X, then this X is called as a neighborhood of, interior point of S. Okay. See the definition of neighborhood. Neighborhood, and the point, the set is called as a neighborhood, whereas the point is called as a interior point. Here, this N is a neighborhood of N, neighborhood of A, and A is a interior of the set N. The definition, the relation between, the same definition of neighborhood, by using the same definition of neighborhood, we have defined that the set is said to be a neighborhood if it is, there exists an open interval I such that A belongs to I and I is a subset of N. Whereas, if A belongs to I and I is a subset of N, then A is called as a interior point of N and N is called as a neighborhood of a point A. And the set of all interior points of a set is called the interior of the set, and we denote it by symbol here S dash or int of S. Okay. Now see what is meant by open set. Next definition, very important definition. A set S is said to be open if it is a neighborhood of each of its points, that is for each x belongs to S, there exists an open interval I x such that x belongs to Ix and Ix is a subset of S. Okay. What is neighborhood? Neighborhood. A N is a neighborhood of a set of a point A. Okay. So there may be a points for which the set is not a neighborhood, okay. But if for every point of the set, if there is an open interval such that x belongs to Ix and Ix is a subset of S, this is for every point, this condition must satisfy for every point. S is set and for every x belongs to S, there exists Ix such that x belongs to Ix and Ix is a subset of S, then S is called as a open set. S is open. This is the definition of open set. Now we can see that according to the definition, R is open because R for every point real number, there exists an open interval I such that x belongs to I and I is a subset of R. So R is an open set. The set Q is a not open because there do not exist I such that x belongs to I and I subset of Q. This condition is not satisfied with the set Q, and therefore Q is not an open set. The closed interval, look at this. This is an interval a comma b. This is an interval is not open. This is not an open set. Okay, this is an interval. I am saying about interval. I am not said about the closed set. Okay, I am saying about an interval. The interval is not an open set because for this end points a and b, there do not exist open interval. For example, if we consider the closed interval 1, 2, then there do not have an open set which contain 1 and contained in this closed interval. If we consider the open interval, suppose 0.9 to 1.1, this is an open interval which contain 1. 1 belongs to this, but it is not a subset of this closed interval 1, 2, since 0.9 is not a member of this closed interval. Okay, so this condition is not happen with these end points 1 and 2, and therefore this closed interval is not a open set. Now we see theorems, examples, and we prove that. See the example, show that every open interval, show that every open interval is an open set. Okay, now you are all familiar with the real line. This is an real line. Consider the open set. Suppose this is my open set a comma b, any open set, open interval. This open interval a to b here, suppose, and this open interval do not contain boundary points a and b. Suppose there is a point x, this is my point x. X belongs to this open interval. Then in particular, to be specific, to get a clear idea, suppose I take here a equal to 1 and b is equal to 5, and suppose x is my 3, then we can see that here I can take, this is an C, that is, this is C where this C is equal to 2, this is D, suppose, then this is D is equal to 4. Then we can see that here A is less than C, less than X, less than D, and less than B. Okay, and see this, this is an open interval, again C comma D. This open interval is subset of open interval A comma B, and here x is member of this, that is, for what is x? X is any point of this open interval. For this open interval, there exists an open interval I such that every, this is for every point, okay, not for a particular points, this is for every point a comma b, there exists interval I such that x belongs to I and I is a subset of, yes, this condition is satisfied. Look at this, for every x there exists an Ix such that x belongs to Ix and Ix is a subset of, yes, this condition is satisfied. Okay, this is for every x belongs to this open interval, and hence this open interval is an open set. Okay, now we show that union of every open set is union of open intervals. What is the problem? Show that every open set is a union of open intervals. Okay, suppose to prove this, let S be open set, and suppose x lambda is a point of S. Now see the definition of open set. When we said open set, for open set there must exist an open interval which contain the point and subset of S. S is a open here. This S is a open set, and therefore there must exist an open interval such that this x lambda belongs to this open interval, and this must be a subset of S because S is open by definition of open set. This condition must be satisfied. Okay. Now thought that this S is union of these all points. What is a x is union of these all points, whatever may be the point in that set. Here capital lambda is an index set. This is index set. Then if we thought that S is a union, then but this union is a subset of this union of open intervals, union of I x lambda. Lambda belongs to capital lambda, and this is subset of S. Okay, look at this, S is a subset of S, and in between this I union of x I lambda I open interval. So this shows that S is equal to union of I x lambda. Lambda belongs to capital lambda. What is capital lambda? Capital lambda is an index set. Whatever may be the point, they are numbered by using this set. Okay, so we have assumed that if S is an open set and x lambda is a point of a set, as S is open, there must exist an open interval which is specified by x I x lambda such that x lambda belongs to I x lambda and I x lambda is subset of S. As we thought, this S open set is written as a union of the points x lambda, then but this union is a subset of union of I x lambda, then these are the subset of S, and therefore union of I x lambda is equal to S, and that is every open set is a union of open intervals. Now we show one theorem. Statement of this theorem what is the interior, the interior of a set is an open set. Open set. What is interior? First, I am writing the definition of interior. Definition of interior. What is the interior? Interior, all interior points of a set is called as a all interior points of a set is called interior. And once again I have written the definition, interior of a set. Okay, what is interior? Here, look at this. If n is a neighborhood, when we said n is a neighborhood of A, there exists an interval I such that A belongs to I subset of n. N is said to be neighborhood of A and I is said to be interior of n. Then collection of all these points is called as an interior of a set. And so to prove this, suppose that interior of a say open set, suppose let S be an open set, S be an open set and S dash is interior of S. S dash is interior of S. Now first possibility, if S dash equal to phi, and we have seen that phi is an open set. Phi is open, therefore there is nothing to prove. Okay. Now if S dash is not equal to phi, S is not empty, that is X be any point of S dash. X is any point of X dash, and here what is a X? X is then, X is interior point of S. Interior point of S, therefore Ix being an open interval, Ix being an open interval is, and Ix is neighborhood then by definition, open interval neighborhood of each of its points. Open interval is an open interval neighborhood of each of its points. Okay, look at this. What is S? What is X? X is any point of S dash, but X is an interior point of S. Interior point, therefore there exists an this open interval by definition of neighborhood. Ix is an open interval, and we have proved that open interval is an neighborhood of each of its point. This is we have proved. Open interval is always a neighborhood of each of its points, and therefore Ix is neighborhood of X. Okay, but what is Ix? Ix is a subset of S. Okay, since every point of Ix is an interior point of S. Every point of Ix is an interior point of S. Okay, and therefore X belongs to Ix and Ix is a subset of S dash, that is any point x of S dash is interior point of S dash, and therefore S dash is open. We have proved. Okay, look at this once again. What we have taken? We have taken set S, and S dash is a interior point. Then there are two possibilities. First possibility, S dash equal to phi. Then phi is a empty set, is a open set. Therefore, S dash is an open set. This is what we want to prove. S dash is a open set. We have to prove. Then S, if S dash is a not empty, S dash is not empty, then X is an interior point. Interior X is any point of S dash. That means X is a interior point of S. When we said it is interior, there must exist an interval, open interval. But open interval is a neighborhood of each of its points. If it is a neighborhood, then every point of Ix is an interior point of S. Okay. Therefore, Ix is a subset of S. Ix is a subset of X. That is, X belongs to Ix. Ix is a subset of S dash. Therefore, any point X of S dash is an interior point of S dash, and hence S dash is a open set. Let us see one more theorem. Theorem: the interior of a set S is the largest open subset of S. So let us see proof. Suppose that S dash is interior of S, where what is S? S is an open set we have taken. And suppose that S1 is any subset of S. We have to show that S1 is a subset of S dash. This is we want to prove. That is, X belongs to, for any point of X, is a point of X dash. This is our target. We have to show that any point of S1 is a point of S dash. Now, let X be a point of S1. X is a point of X1. Since an open set is neighborhood of each of its point, we have taken here S is a, S1 is any open subset. Okay. Therefore, S1, and S1 is neighborhood of each of its points. If it is a neighborhood of each points, therefore, S1 is neighborhood of X. This S1 is neighborhood of X, and this implies that X is interior point of S1. Interior point of S. S1 is a neighborhood. That is, here X belongs to S1, since S1 is a neighborhood and S1 is a subset of S. So this shows that this X is a interior point of S. X is an interior point, means X is a point of S dash. That is, X belongs to S1 implies that X belongs to S dash, and therefore S dash, that is the interior of a set S, is the largest open subset of S. So friends, we have shown what is meant by neighborhood, what is meant by open set, and we have proved two theorems regarding the open set. And again, some examples of open sets with their thank you all for watching the video and having with me. Thanks for once again watching this video.